Welcome back. We are at the farm today doing some drip line irrigation. Says it's supposed to rain a little after 9. It's about 7:30 today on this Easter Eve, and we got drops already coming down. But that's alright. It is what it is. Like I said, we're working on the drip line here. I'm almost done with this row. I started a video, but kept dropping the camera, and then it turned upside down. It was a bad one. So I'm almost done with this line here, so we'll go ahead and finish this bed. You guys can watch, and then the next one, I'll say more towards it. Next, this one. There we go. But, yep. So we'll be doing this today until the rain becomes unbearable. Hopefully that won't be for a little bit, so I can get at least some of this done. So you see, we're putting down this beautiful little drip line. Forgot which size this one is. One of the smaller ones here. I think it's like the orange and the blue line are the bigger, more industrial size ones. But this one here, we're trying
to put a little tippity tips on these. Where's the bag? All right. These bad boys here. What we're doing is we're trying to put this tip line. Where's that? We're just trying to put this in here. Pull this off to the side. Get a little space. Fold it twice. And this should stop the water from coming out from this end here. Build enough pressure, send it through the little holes. And that should be enough. Okay. Hope everyone's having a good old day. I'm enjoying this weather. This is nice and cool. Right before the heat starts to really kick in, now that it is officially spring. It's crazy enough to think, right before spring we had, literally the last day of winter, we had an 80 degree day. And now, April's not even looking like it's going to have that for the first 2 weeks or so. So that should be interesting. So that's weather for you. I hope you guys can see this. Maybe past that sprinkler there. Maybe get past another piece. Yeah, there's the look. I think we can have to get past. That's crazy. You have the opening on this side. There we go. Just gotta fit it in.
in for the next one. Pop the tops in there, probably.
These are easy, you just gotta push them through.
Pull a little bit on my side. Oh, that one got chewed up. That one got.
Seems over the winter time we had this all covered up. Looks like something was crawling around underneath it all. And to get their moisture, they chewed on these. So we're having to replace. Replace a good portion of them, so that point became
screw it. Why don't we just replace all of them?
So a tubing is like 4 cents a foot. And these things here are like $2 a piece. You bet your ass this thing is worth it.
Here's me from wanting to set this all up in my own backyard. At the same time, you don't want to waste the rain. And you're in an area that gets less than a foot of rain a year. I mean, yeah, you're kind of stuck with having to provide your own artificial hydration. You know what I mean? Well, that's gardening. Alright, let's get to it. Grab my line, we drag that down. Yeah, this part has a lot of weight tighten it down, see where we're at. So push this one a little bit further on. And we'll do this one. Should be fine. Yep, back in the pocket. Trying to get better at this one. At least taking consideration like the angle and what you guys could possibly see. And then trying to flare with either keeping it at normal zoom or pull back into the ultra wide, but then it's kind of fishbowly or with the details and all. So that part I kind of want to stay away from. And then you can see better. It does sometimes feel like you gotta be close up with it in order to be able to see properly. You know, like using the weights down on the other end there, that I can still pull this out from underneath if I really mean to. But if not, then you can just give a little tug to straighten it all out. Alright. Let's run this one more time. Yep, that's what I kept doing last time. Good job. Good job. That feels pretty bumpy to be out. Gotta establish some more secure and stable fanny pack mode. Fold it on an angle. That's
pull it all the way through. Golly. Oh, that ain't going nowhere, shit.
Connecting lines to here, and running them the length you need, and pinching them off at the end, and then, making sure you got what you're looking for. I'm gonna push these off to the side so that we can start growing like we did over there. Yeah. 30 somewhat more beds today. Maybe you don't want to stick around for all that, but I thank you for sticking around now. And until then, stay dry.